Blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. We are now on the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time with the theme, Love is Divine. Please all kneel for the Oratio Imperata for peace. God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice, we humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lady, Queen of Peace, Saint Michael the Archangel, Saint Joseph, Saint Francis of Assisi, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, Saint Sebastian, please be seated. Let me read to you the circular letter number 2024-018 from the Roman Catholic Bishop of Bacolod, Diocese of Bacolod. Greetings of peace. As we commence the month of October, which is dedicated to Our Lady of the Rosary, the second patroness of our diocese, I would like to take this opportunity to inform you of the various diocesan activities planned for this special time. First, the Living Rosary. I encourage all parishes and chaplaincies to pray the Holy Rosary daily to deepen devotion to Our Lady. I also invite everyone to organize a Living Rosary on October 7, 2024 in support of Aid to the Church in Needs campaign. 1 million children praying the Rosary. Kindly share your Living Rosary activity on the diocesan social communication channels via Facebook Adsum, Diocese of Bacolod, or through your parish Facebook page. Second, the Solemnity of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. In line with a decree of His Excellency Vicente M. Navarra Didi, we will celebrate the Solemnity of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. our second patroness on October 13, 2024, Sunday. There will be a concelebrated Mass at San Sebastian Cathedral on the same date at 10 a.m. Everyone is cordially invited. With confidence in your continued support, I entrust our diocese to the loving intercession of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, praying that she guides us ever closer to Christ as we journey together in faith, hope, and love. With my prayers and pastoral blessing, Patricio A. Buzon, SDB, DD, Bishop of Bacolod, by order of His Excellency, Reverend Father Marvin H. Labasan, Chancellor Secretary. Dear brothers and sisters, the institution of marriage has always been under attack. Entering a marriage with either or both partners are ill-prepared does not help the resulting union. The pressures of modern living further weaken it. Many no longer consider marriage as a lifetime commitment. Questioned about divorce, Jesus points to the beginning of creation and declares that what God has joined together, no human being must separate. May the Eucharist unite married couples more intimately with Christ, that they may witness to God's faithful love for His church. Let us now rise as we welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Marvin Labasan.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins and ask the Father's forgiveness. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
God in the highest.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace on earth, peace to people. Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpassed the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. God made man and woman for each other, and in marriage made the two of them one. In the Gospel, Jesus refers to this original will of God in prohibiting divorce. The first reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them became one flesh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the Lord bless.
By becoming man and experiencing the bitterness of death, Jesus becomes a brother to men and women and brings them back to the love of God. The second reading.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, he for a little while was made lower than the angels, that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the leader to their salvation perfect through suffering. He who consecrates and those who are being consecrated all have one origin. Therefore, he is not ashamed to call them brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand.
If we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees approached Jesus and asked, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So, they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Maayong aga sa inyong tanan. Have you ever tried building something or working on something but you lack the patience to see it through? Ano ang nagakatabo when you try to build something beautiful but lack the patience to see it through? This question speaks not only to marriage, but to every part of life. Tanan kita, may mga tinion nga ginsuguran naton mag-ubra sang isa ka butang nga puno sang kalipay, puno sang handom, puno sang enerhiya, like a new project, a new job, a new relationship, or a new phase in life. But then, when the work became too hard, or the results did not come quickly enough, we are tempted to immediately give up. Today, we live in a time where convenience and instant gratification dominate our lives. If something becomes too challenging, we are told that we have the right to walk away, that we have the right to move on, or to find something better. But the question we need to ask ourselves is, can something truly beautiful ever be built without struggle? Can something truly beautiful ever be built without patience or without sacrifice? In marriage, this is especially true. Couples often enter into marriage with a sense of hope and idealism, believing that their love will grow stronger, that their life will come easy, and that everything will be perfect. Sa pila ka mga tuig sang akon pagkapari, ikapito pa man lang ako magkasal. So kung gusto niyo magdugang, pwede pa. Sa pito ko nga mga ginkasal, makita ko gid ining idealismo sang kabuhi kag sang paghigugma nga wala sing katapusan. Ang paglaom nga ang ila paghigugma maglambo, nga ang ila pagupod mangin masulhay. But you know that love is not something that always feels good. Love is a choice, a commitment to the other person, even when things become difficult. When the initial excitement fades, and couples are left with the everyday challenges of life, and the temptations to think nga, hindi amo ini ang akon ginsudlan. Hindi amo ini nga kabuhi ang akon ginhandom. Hindi ini ang mga klase sang pamilya ang akon ginatuyo. But in those moments, what is really happening? Are we encountering an obstacle that tells us to abandon the relationship? Or are we being invited into a deeper form of love? Sa panahon sang pagtilaw kag kabudlayan, panahon man ini para magtuon kita nga mangin pasinsyoso sa aton ginahigugma. For it is patience alone that can transform the initial spark of romance into something profound and enduring. Subo nga ang mangunguma na kahibalo that a beautiful garden takes time, tending and care, and so does marriage. Marriage requires the same attention and perseverance. But when the couples lack the patience to see it through, ginakuha man nila ang posibilidad nga makita ang katahom nga iya sini ginadala. Kun sa dutay nga mga pagtilaw kag indi pagintindihanay, mag-give up na sila dayon nga duwa, ginkuha man nila ang posibilidad nga makita nila ang katahom nga dala sang ila pagpangasawa. When Jesus speaks about marriage in the gospel, he does not describe it as something temporary. Siling niya, what God has joined together, let no man separate. This is not just a commandment. This is an invitation to trust that God has a purpose in keeping two people together. Even when the roads get tough, you know, after the fall of Adam and Eve, ang tanan nga grasya ginkuha sa ila magluwas sa isa. Nagpabilin sila nga duwa nga mag-asawa. Amo ina kabilidhon ang sakramento sang kasal nga maski ang orihinal nga sala hindi makapanas sa iya. Sanggin anaw ang bulog nga kalibutan sang tsimpo ni Noe. Ang tanan nga tawo ginpanas man iya. Pero may isa ka grasya nga ginbili niya. Ano ina? Nga si Noe kag ang iya panimalay, magapabilin nga isa ka pamilya, kag sila nga duwa, mangin mag-asawa. Even when the road gets tough, the vision of love, according to God, it means that it does not run away when things get difficult. Ang paghigugma nga ginatuyo sang Dios, amo ang paghigugma nga nagapili kag nagapabilin. Not only when the time is favorable, but more so when it is not. The struggle is part of the process. The difficulty is part of what makes love mature and grow. When you encounter trials in your marriage, they are not meant to signal the end. Instead, they invite you to go deeper, to refine your love, and to make it stronger. If you give up too soon, you never get to see the fullness of what could have been. A love that mirrors God's own love for us, faithful, patient, and enduring. You know, the most beautiful couples and families that I know are not the ones nga nangin masulhay kag mahapos ang ila pag-asawahay. Kung hindi yadtong ginatilawan kag gintisingan ang ila pagpalanggaanay, hindi lamang sang makaisa ka beses, kung hindi sa damo-damo nga beses. So kung pamangkuton naton ang aton mga kaugalingon, what happens when we try to build something beautiful but lack the patience to see it through? The answer is clear. We will miss out the beauty that comes only through perseverance. In a world that encourages us to leave when things get tough, God calls us to stay, endure, and trust that He is working something beautiful through our mess and challenges, through your mess and challenges. Remember that the beauty of marriage lies not in the perfection, but in the journey. It is in choosing to love even when it is difficult, in forgiving even when it is impossible, in trusting that God's plans for love always require patience and perseverance. No one is perfect, and marriage is not a journey to perfection. If anything, marriage only reveals your imperfections even more. Every marriage at its core is a covenant between two imperfect people, two individuals carrying their own unique wounds, their own shortcomings, their own baggages, coming together with all that they are. And this is where the miracle happens. Ang sakramento sang kasal, wala nagapabalaan sa mga mag-asawa kay bangod perpekto siya nga bana o kung perpekto siya nga asawa. Kung hindi, bangod kay kulang sila. Kagamo ini ang nagahatag sang posibilidad kag espasyo agud mag-intra ang Dios sa ila istorya. The sacrament of marriage does not sanctify couples because they are perfect. It sanctifies them precisely because they are not. The role of God in marriage then is to take those crack, those flaw, those struggle, and fill them with His grace. What makes a marriage holy is not that the husband and wife never fight, never disagree, or never fail each other. What makes it holy is that in those moments of failure, they allow God to enter and transform them. They chose to embrace the fact that they are not enough on their own, but with God's grace, they can be more than enough for each other. When we surrender to this process, we begin to experience the beauty of the plan of God, one that is far more fulfilling than anything we could build on our own. So let us ask ourselves today, are we willing to see things through even when they get hard? Do we trust that God is doing something beautiful in the midst of your struggles? And do you have the patience to wait for that beauty to unfold? God's love for us never abandons, never gives up. May we reflect that same love in our relationship, especially in marriage, and trust in the beauty that only time and patience can reveal. Divorce is never in the plan of God. It was only permitted by Moses because they are hard-headed, tig-a-ulo. In many ways, divorce is a rejection of grace that accompanies every marriage. It is in the moment when we chose to stop believing that God can make something beautiful out of our brokenness. It is the desire to play God. Ang pagdiborsyo
handom ini nga mangin parihos sa Dios. Sa isa ka pamalandong nga ako nabasahan kagabi, siling niya, divorce is not just the breaking of a human bond. It is the rejection of the divine hand that promised to mend what is broken and to heal what is wounded. When you chose divorce, you are simply telling God that I no longer trust you to make something holy out of this mess. Yes, marital problems are true. The struggle is real. But so is the grace of God that binds couple together. Kung mag-give up kang bangindi ka mo sa mga jutay nga pagtilaw nga mag-aabot sa inyo, paano mag-intra kag magsulod ang Dios sa kabuhi ninyo? They say, it takes two to marry. It takes two to stay in marriage. But it takes three to remain committed. Ikaw, ang imo bana, ang imo asawa, kag ang inyo Dios. Paintraha ang Dios sa inyo pag-asawahay. Paintraha ang Dios sa inyo pagpuyo. Kay ang aton paghigugma, hindi ini perfect. Pero ang Ginoo ta, perpekto siya. Kag ang iyalang gugma, ang magabind sa inyo nga duwa. Kung tuod nga may problema ang pag-asawahay, tuod man nga may grasya ang pagpakasal. Kag kung gasalig ka sa sininga grasya, mangin mapesensyoso ka sa sining proseso nga ginaagyan ninyo, nga ginaagyan sang tag sa kapamilya. Kay ang ina nga mga pagtilaw, alagyan ina sang grasya, agod nga magpabalaan sa inyo nga duwa.
Please all stand, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Father, you raise marriage and family life into a living sacrament of your life and love. We pray to you that the bonds of love may grow stronger in and among us. In trust, we pray. Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May church leaders continue to guide married couples and their families with listening and understanding hearts, just as Jesus did, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May those who are in public office create programs that help families develop mutual love and understanding without compromising human dignity, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the leaders of our nation speak out bravely against various evils that degrade the dignity of the human person and destroy the environment, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May married couples who are having difficulties in their relationships be able to reach out to each other so that they may grow in faithfulness and love. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May all those suffering for the sake of the gospel find hope and healing in the loving care of Jesus, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the dead attain the eternal vision of heaven so that they may gain the future resurrection, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
We also include in our prayer all the sick, especially Evelyn Law, and all those who take care of them, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, strengthen the bonds of love that keep us together as one family in Christ. May this love be manifested in our words and deeds. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image, and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so, With all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Sebastian, Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Is so the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now pray the prayer for the Diocesan Pastoral Assembly 3. Together, Almighty and ever-loving God,
we come before you as members of your flock, seeking your guidance and blessings for the fruitfulness of our Third Diocesan Pastoral Assembly. Send forth your Spirit upon us to direct our discernment. Bestow upon us the wisdom and clarity to hear each other well, and help us to be sensitive to the signs of our times. May our synodal discussions be fruitful, reflect your will, and align with your divine plan. Bless the leaders of our church, that they may guide us with wisdom and humility. Help us to grow in faith and unity. May this assembly inspire a time of renewal, preparing us to go forth as missionary disciples. May we be good and faithful stewards of your mysteries and gift, so that we may bring your light and love to those we meet, doing our share in the realization of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lady of the Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Saint Sebastian,
pray for us.
Please be seated for a while. Announcement. This coming October 12 to 14, we will be having our Triduum of Masses in honor of our Holy Mother, Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, at our usual 6:30 a.m. Mass. On her feast day, October 15, Tuesday, also at 6:30 a.m. You are all lovingly invited. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and mind in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Amen. Go in the love of Christ. Our Mass has ended.
Thanks be to God.